Hi guys, welcome to WebSensePro. Welcome to another video related to Shopify. And in this video, I'll walk you through step-by-step process on how you can install latest version of Google Analytics to your Shopify store using native Shopify app. Google has stopped supporting the old Universal Analytics version of Google Analytics, and they have updated it to Google Analytics 4. And it is mandatory for you to update that into the newer version because the old Universal Analytics of Google Analytics will not show any reporting to you anymore. So stick to the video, and in this video, I'll walk you through a step-by-step process on how you can do that using native Shopify app. So don't forget to subscribe the channel, comment on the video below, stick to the video. Without further ado, let's get started. So guys, first step is to create a new Google Analytics property. And to create a new property, we'll navigate to analytics.google.com. And from there, you will see a screen similar to this one. So I already have multiple properties already created, which are mostly from my clients. You might not see that, but you should be able to see a gear icon on the bottom left corner where it says admin. Click on that. And there you will see a button called create account. Click on that create account button. Name your account. So I'm going to name it YouTube tutorial for now. And then scroll down to the bottom. There you will have a next button showing up. Click on that. And from there, we will name our YouTube property. Again, I'm going to name it YouTube tutorial for now. You can name it whatever you want as per your website or as per your requirement. Okay, then click on next again and select the category of your website. I'm going to select computers and electronics for now. You can choose as per your niche of the website. So business size, you can select as per your requirement. I'm going to select medium for now. Click on next after that. Then you can select the business object of what is your objective to create this Google Analytics property. My object is to examine the user behavior of my Shopify store. So I'm going to check that. You can check drive online sales, generate leads, whatever your goal is. Okay, then click on create button next and check mark the data processing terms, then click on I accept, and here you go. Our Google Analytics property has been created. Now we will choose a platform web as we are installing this on our Shopify store, and here we will add the URL of the store. I'm going to install that on my development Shopify store, which is dev.websensepro.myshopify.com. So I'm just going to copy the URL, paste it here, remove the HTTPS because it's already showing up here, and name the website, and then click on create stream. Okay, we are done with the creation of analytics property. Now it's the installation part. We can manually install that to our Shopify theme.liquid file. But in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can do that using a native Shopify app. Okay, so let's go to the backend of the Shopify store, which I have. Okay, now before installing my Google Analytics using the native Shopify app, what I'm going to do is check that whether if I already have the Google Analytics code installed. So if you have that installed, you should have that in your theme.liquid file. So let's check that first, that if we have that code already, so we don't duplicate the data, right? So click on online store. And then from here, I have my activated theme, the latest version of Dawn. Click on these three small dots and click on edit code. And from there, I have my theme.liquid file already open. You can click theme.liquid file from your left hand menu and search for G tag. And here you will see the code. As you can see, the code of Google Analytics installed in my theme.liquid file. So that's the manual way of installing Google Analytics to your Shopify store, but I'm doing that using a native Shopify app. So for now, I'm going to remove that code and click save. The reason why I'm removing that is that we don't want any duplicate data. So if we install that using Shopify native app, and we already have the code in our theme.liquid file too, so we'll have the duplicate data, right? So let's go back, and there's one more place where we could have the code of Google Analytics, which could be in settings. And then we have checkout. Click on checkout from the left hand menu and scroll down to the bottom. You have that additional order status page or you have additional scripts here. Where it is. Yep. So additional scripts here. You might have Google Analytics code already here, or you might have a Google Tag Manager where you may have GA tag in your Google Tag Manager account. If you don't know about Google Tag Manager, I already have created a complete course regarding how you can install Google Analytics, Facebook Pixel and other stuff using Google Tag Manager. I'll add the link in the video description, or you will see somewhere on the screen as well. Okay, so for now, I'm going to remove this Google Tag Manager account as well, because I don't want to pull the Google Tag or Google Analytics from Google Tag Manager. Okay, after removing this additional scripts code, I'm going to click on Save button here. Now let's install the app which Shopify has provided to install Google Analytics. So I'm going to close that, go back to the dashboard of my Shopify, click on Preferences from the left-hand menu. And here we have this Google Analytics section, and you can see Google Analytics 4 is through Google Channel app. So I'm going to click on this Manage Pixel here button. And once you do that, you will have a screen like this where you will be able to install an app which is called Google and YouTube. So click on Add Sales Channel. You can alternatively search this on Google and install from Shopify App Store as well. But that's the easiest way to do that. Just click on Preferences and go to Google section and add the sales channel. And after that, click on Add Sales Channel button here. Okay, after adding the sales channel, you will have a screen like this, where all you need to do is just click on this Connect button, and it will show a pop-up where it will ask you to connect your Google account. So I'm connecting my Google account through which I created the new analytics, which I showed you guys before. So click on this, and it's asking to allow the permissions. Scroll down and click on Allow, so Google Analytics can get the data from your Shopify store. Okay, now as I told you guys, I have multiple Google Analytics properties on my Google account. So I'm going to click on this drop down and select the one which I need to track it for. So I named my Google Analytics property as YouTube tutorial when I was creating it. So select that one and then click on Connect. And that's it. So in these three simple steps, you can connect your Google Analytics 4 property. First, we created a new Google Analytics property using a free Gmail email account. Second is to install the Google and YouTube sales channel app. And third is to connect that. And that's pretty much it. Your Google Analytics has been installed. Now I'm going to test it and see if it's showing up the reports. So guys, our GA4 property has started collecting the data, and it's collecting the real-time data. So whoever visits the website, it will show all of the events. So as you can see, it's showing up page view, user engagement, and it's showing if someone added the product to cart. So I have the website open in incognito window, and I visited few of the pages, and after adding the product to the cart, I landed onto checkout page, and you can see the whole journey here. So it showed the page view, user engagement, then added the product to cart. And then if I click on here, it shows me begin checkout. So it's saving all of the data in your Google Analytics, and it will show you how many visitors got till checkout, how many abandoned carts or etc. All of the reports you will get in Google Analytics. And if you click on add to cart event, you can further see what's the currency of that product. What's the total value of that product and all of the information. Similarly, if you go to the checkout, begin checkout event, you will have the info of the currency. So as you can see, I have USD as currency, and the total value of the checkout is 10. So if I go to my checkout page, you can see that it's $10 product which I added to cart and went through till checkout page. So that's all of the data collected in Google Analytics, and you can make better decision of Google Ads, Google Search, and all of your advertisement budget. You can have it tracked in Google Analytics and make better decision of where you will need to be investing in order to increase your sales. So that's it for the tutorial, guys. I wanted to show you an easier way on how you can install GA4 to your Shopify store. And until next video, have a great day.